I received an email from Rick, who had heard me on my Coach Robb podcast talking about the difference of running out of breath being an aerobic function, or is that an anaerobic threshold function? Wanted to elaborate a little bit further in this video here today. When you find yourself running out of breath, the most important thing to understand is, what is your heart rate at that moment you realize you're starting to run out of breath? That's the easiest way that I could break down a complicated concept. When you're in your true aerobic zone, that would be zone 2 and below, based off of your max heart rate to the discipline that you're doing. So let's take something like running. If you know what your max heart rate is on a run effort, and you're training in heart rate zone 2 and you're running out of breath, that's when you know that you need to work on your aerobic capacity. Now, keep in mind, when we look at not being able to deliver oxygen at a low intensity, that can be a byproduct of being dehydrated and not being muscularly strong. Very important that you keep that in the back of your mind. Most of us, we perceive when we start to breathe hard as it's a cardiovascular issue, and of course it could be part of the equation, but remember, if you're dehydrated, that's going to artificially elevate the heart rate, and if you're muscularly weak, you're going to be working harder to go at an easy pace. When we go to the other end of the spectrum on, do you need to work on your anaerobic threshold, your lactate tolerance, your sprint speed, your top end speed, whatever adjective you want to give it, this is where we look at a concept that's called critical speed numbers. Now, it's beyond the scope of this video, but with my clients, we know where's that threshold that we know we should be able to maintain based on our current level of fitness that's been extrapolated from our last round of assessments that are no more than 6 to 8 weeks old. So when we find that you're going at a speed that is beyond what you're capable of, that's what we refer to as your critical speed number. We have a very specific formula on how we calculate it. The idea here is you have to have some basis of reference to be able to answer the question, is it an aerobic issue or is it an anaerobic threshold issue? Completely different energy systems altogether. So I wanted to make sure that I got back to the original question. What do I mean between the two? If you know you're training with accurate heart rate zones, which, by the way, our heart rate spreadsheet can be found in the description box below, so please make sure that you're utilizing it so that this concept is very quantified and specific for you. If you know you're training in heart rate zone 2 and you're running out of breath, you need to work on your aerobic function, assuming that you're physically strong and you're properly hydrated. When we get to the top end of working threshold sprint speed, we need to know where's that heart rate number begin, and then make sure that you don't go 8 or 10 or even 12 beats beyond it, because then you're just simply going to go too far anaerobic, and then you're going to have to go backwards. So zoom out. Let's make sure this makes sense. When we're trying to work on our top end speed, we only want to get right up against that glass ceiling and just a little bit beyond it, a very little bit, maybe 1 to 2 beats. That's where we get the term lactate threshold. You can improve that threshold, that lactate tolerance, becoming more tolerant of the presence of lactic acid. Bunch of big words, but you're feeling it while you're out there. I want you to have a better understanding of what it is. Once you identify, is it an aerobic issue or is it a threshold issue, you need to make sure that when you press the threshold, you don't go too far beyond it, because you're just simply going to blow up and go backwards. So, very observant question that came off the podcast show. I hope that makes a little bit more sense. If you happen to have a question such as this, please do me a favor and send it to me and my team. Every day here on YouTube, we're launching a new video every morning, so please make sure you subscribe and turn on the notifications. But please send me your questions to contact@coachrobb.com. I appreciate your time today, and I hope to see you again tomorrow morning.